What's that giggling maniacally in Granny's ancient attic? When your car gets stuck in the muddy, storm-struck English countryside, you will inevitably spot the old, ominous house where you must seek shelter. Within, you shall discover the dreadfully joyful answer and the source of witchy enchantment. Herbert Masterframe here, revisiting a horror film I saw when I was about 7 years old. Its quaint grotesquery has stayed with me since. So, on a rainy, windy night, I faced the demon dolls again. Our grim fairy tale begins on such a night. A man and a woman are driving down an empty road. They have a young daughter who clenches her favorite teddy bear in the back seat. The man and woman are her dad and stepmother, and they are among the cruelest, most detestable adults in all of cinema. They are also the true monsters of jestful horror writer and director Stuart Gordon's Little People Slaughterhouse. The stepmother is cold-blooded and Cruella de Vil-style cruel, and her father is a selfish prick. When the dolls come alive in the night with their sinister, childlike grimaces and sharp animal teeth, it is a delight to see these puppet imps mutilate these imaginationless walking corpses. The film, in fact, like Pixar's oversold toys franchise, is about the wonder of our childhood emblems and our loving relationship with inanimate objects. But in the grandfatherly toy maker's deadly dollhouse, the naturally morbid and innocent tendency to fantasize about horrid things becomes the death of those who cease to dream. There is a storybook moral to this bite-sized torture eroticism, the opposite of today's pointless, ceaseless horror porn. The roles of Mr. and Mrs. Hartwig as the ideal grandparents with dark secrets are fantastically dressed and acted by Guy Rolfe and Hilary Mason. They bring an unsettling warmth and wise calm to the candlelit corridors of their big, spooky mansion. All the characters are as wonderfully detailed as the dolls they're surrounded by. The bumbling man-child Ralph, who is pure of heart, but mistaken for a perverted psycho, makes a charming, unlikely hero. And the goth punk hitchhiker girls are fun as thieving fresh meat for little dolly knives. The set and cinematography evoke Geppetto's workshop, if it was made in hell, and the twitchy stop-motion animation befits the creepiness of the wicked puppet killers. All this delighted and frightened me as a child. Watching it again as an adult, I appreciated the wicked funhouse humor and the perfectly rendered details, such as the oily blackened skulls under the cracked bright porcelain cherub faces when Enid kicks the crap out of some nasty dolls. After the longest night on earth, in one of the shorter horror features, we are treated to a satisfying and strangely happy ending. But the dolls have asked that I say no more. You must enter the house for yourself. Whether you live to tell about it or not will be a matter of what's in your heart. Rest in peace, Stuart Gordon. May you make a sequel in the haunted house of heaven. I give doll 6 out of 6 plucked out eyeball.